It is time for Fifth Host when we talk about what you're talking about. Well, Merriam-Webster has added a new definition to a well-known pronoun. Here it is. They now refers to a single person whose gender identity is non-binary. And this might help explain it a bit more. So for males, proper pronouns include he, him, his. Females' proper pronouns include she, her, and hers. And for people who don't identify as either male or female, pronouns are they, them, their. And speaking of which, singer Sam Smith has now asked to be referred to as they. Smith said they no longer prefer to go by male pronouns. So DBL Nation, we gotta hear from you. Should you be expected to ask people what their preferred pronoun is? Please chime in. Erica, take it away.
Joe from Facebook says, dictionaries are considered to be constitutional and help provide us with the right language for human beings. Let's be mindful and make the first step in respectfully meeting other humans. Joe, thank you for chiming in. I just wanted to read an excerpt from my little sister Ebony's article called Why I Don't Correct Pronouns. I am a queer black woman who can and has passed as a male. Growing up, it would bother me when people would refer to me as a boy or when kids would be kids and pick on me for my appearance. But as I got older and more comfortable with myself, my only goal was to be happy. This did not stop people from yelling at me, jumping over the door, or kicking in the stall door in the women's restrooms. My sister recently told us that she wants to be referred to as they, and that was something that I thought was super brave of her to come forward and say that, because I know how hard things have been for her. So when people feel like they don't need to respect someone based on how they want to be identified and how they want to be spoken to, I feel like it's more a projection of your self-hatred, because no one should have to live like that.
Thank you for sharing that with us, Erica.
That was amazing.
And thank you to Ebony for allowing you to share that with us. That's personal. Thank you.
Ray from Facebook says, I don't ask what people's astrological sign is. I doubt I'll ask what their preferred pronoun is. I can't even remember people's names. I'll start with that. Here's my thing. I get what you're saying. It's difficult. Any change is difficult, but we have to adjust to society. Here's my thing. I'm being respectful. If I'm like, excuse me, ma'am, excuse me, sir, if I get it wrong and you want me to call you they, please respect that I'm coming from a place of respect. And if you try to throw that back in my face, that's where I'm going to get mad. If you're like, I'm a they, you better get it right, blah, 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 then I have a problem with that. We're all learning. If I make a mistake, please correct me in the right way, respectfully, and I think it'll go a long way for everybody else.
Right. And, you know, I have a comment to read, but I'll just say, to your point, Jeff, I have a nephew that's trans. And, you know, he and I had a conversation because he was upset with certain family members that were still calling him by his former name. And I talked to him, and I was like, we all love you, and we are all in this transition with you. So the word transition means that things are evolving.
Yeah.
So, like, give especially your older family members a second.
Yes.
Give them a second to breathe. And now it's so common, and it's not a discussion anymore.
Right. But because it's not being disrespectful
at all.
Right.
It just takes a second.
Right. Yeah. Right.
I just hope everyone is as considerate and inclusive as this panel.
I think you'd be surprised. A lot of people are.
Right.
There's a lot of good in this world.
I really do hope so.